guys, and welcome back to my channel. If it's your first time joining me, I'm tamaracanham, and as usual, thank you for clicking on that video. So today we are creating a Valentine's dye look, you guys. It is a bit extra, it's very extra, but I really did enjoy creating this look. I hope you guys enjoy it as well, and if you want to see how I got this look, continue watching the video. What is wrong with me? Okay, so for foundation, I'm going to be going in with the Avon and the Wet n Wild together on my face. I've already spot treated my face before I put on my foundation and did all the usuals. So I'm just going to now I love this foundation, you guys, but the only problem is the formula is just so amazing, but the creases it leaves in your smile lines are just not cool. But the formula is really, really, really amazing for a formula that's just 100 gem. I'm sorry, I'm all over the place today. Whoops. Okay, I'm trying to rush, that's why I'm all over the place. And then I'm going to add some of the Avon over that, just to kind of brighten it, because I'm not going to be going in with any concealer. And this shade is actually not my shade, it's actually darker, but because of the lighting and everything, sometimes foundations tend to make you look lighter on camera. So I'm going to just lighten this. Oh my gosh, it's perfect. Ooh. Wow. This combo is actually quite nice. I don't normally use this foundation because it's very sheer for my liking. Okay, yeah. But I'm just gonna let this dry for a few minutes. That's what I normally do, but like, do I really have the time right now? Like, if you let it dry, it's gonna thicken and you're just gonna get more coverage out of your foundations. Also with your concealers, you can do the same thing, but kind of because I'm rushing, I'm just gonna quickly go right ahead and start blending this in. And I've already spot sheeted, so as you can see, all the marks on my face are covered and concealed. So I'm just gonna quickly step under my eyes as well as over my eyebrows, and I'm gonna let the product dry a little bit more before I go in and set the rest of my face. Just because sometimes it can cause caking under the skin if the product is too wet, and this combo is very dewy, so I don't want to set it immediately. Just under my eyes as well, only, and just kind of with all my eyebrows, because I want to start off with my eyebrows. And the reason why I'm powdering my eyebrows today is because I'm going to go in with a liquid lipstick, and just to kind of make sure that it sticks. Normally I wouldn't put powder over my foundation, just over my eyebrows, just so that the powder that I normally use can grip. Let me stop babbling. So I'm going to be going in with this Huda Beauty liquid lipstick. Since this is a Valentine's look, I'm kind of going for pinks and red kind of looks, you know, in that kind of family. So all the colors we're going to be used today are going to be related in the red or pinkish family. So I'm going to take the shade and just do my brows. That is so much better. Oh my god. Just try not to make a mistake like I have. It's going to be so hard to clean that up. What do you guys think? Should I maybe go in with a darker shade? And then just go in with the rest of the product in the front of your eyebrows. Kind of shade it in so that you don't look crazy. So I'm just going in with this more purpley shade, and I'm just adding it slightly over slightly over the edges, just to kind of darken this. harder than I thought it was going to be. Okay, that seems to be fine. It's going to be such a mission to conceal that because I did make some boo-boos. Okay, so I'm going to do the same on my other eyebrow. So now I'm going to go in with some concealer. I've already started the other brow. I'm going to go in with some concealer. This is the LA Girl Pro Concealer, just to conceal under my brows and just to perfect it because I did make some boo-boos. So what you should do is you should actually also have a cloth next to you so that you can kind of like wipe off. So you don't want to kind of like drag your product like this because otherwise your concealer is going to get pink. So you just kind of want to make little strokes at a time and sort of like dab the strokes on, if that makes sense. Just picking up some product. And also just kind of wait for the eyebrows to dry because this is really dried. Because it is a matte liner. Okay. I'm going to clean it up and just kind of drag this down. I'm going to let this side dry. In the meantime, I am going to... Where's my brush? You guys, I've not cleaned my brushes this week and it's so annoying. I'm gonna have to And I am going to go in with the shade. I'm sorry, I can't go too close up. My skin has been giving me hell. So, and I'm just going to kind of focus that in my crease because we are going to kind of create a cut crease from that end. Like I said, we're just going to be starting off with red shades in the palette. Dust that off. This is actually going to be so nice. Just kind of focus the shade in the crease. We do have concealer that's still wet, so let's just damp and kind of swoop it out. So once you fold this up, sweep it out. And you are just gonna kind of feather out the edges of your concealer, of your eyeshadow. Just diffuse that so that it's really soft and nice. Okay. Yeah, this is working perfect. So I changed my mind and I'm actually going in with this white shade in the palette. there. And I'm just gonna set that with that shade. Okay. So now I'm going back in with the lipstick that we use to kind of go over our eyebrows with the same shade. We're gonna go in and we're gonna create a nice wing liner. So back in with these two shades, just kind of mix them together. We'll see if the first shade is just gonna be good enough for that. So my camera stopped recording, but what I'm going to do now, I'm going to go back with the shade and I'm going to take it underneath my eye. As you can see, I finished doing my wing. I kind of went over it with the same shade. I went in with the lipstick, then I shaded over it with the same color that I'm putting under my eyes. Just going to dust it off and I'm going to put it under my eyes. We're not going to take it all the way, just until like there or so. Now I'm going to go in with some mascara. I already went with some mascara on my upper lashes. I'm going to do my lower lash now. And yeah. So I'm going to go back into this Beauty Treats palette and I'm going to be using the bronzer, which is this shade right over here. I'm just going to be bronzing up my cheeks. This is generally my favorite concealer. I mean, this is like my favorite. So now I kind of cut out some hearts because I couldn't get stickers. I didn't have time to go into the store. And I am going to get a brush. I'm just hoping this works. I'm going to get a brush and we are going to make some hearts over our faces. I'm going to mix the same shade that I've been using, this shade. I'm not sure if I should also go in with the pink, maybe from this one, it's too light. Let's try the next palette. Oh, these kids broke this palette. It's like ruined. I have to even throw this damn thing away. Okay, now let's use the same shade. These children. Okay. So we're going to go back in with the same shade we've been using over our eyes. And because... Oops, sorry. I'm going to kind of place it over here. And I'm just going to hope it works because I couldn't find some stickers. It wasn't the most perfect, but it did what I wanted it to do. So now I'm going to have to kind of bring this down. Shade it in. And now I'm going to take the small one that I have, which is kind of like bugging me. Oh my God, now my mirror is messed up. I'm gonna place this down, let's say over here. Bring in a little bit more here. Just kind of shade over it. Make sure you don't go over that line right over there. So crazy. I kind of want to go in with this Catrice shade, with this Catrice palette, and just dab in some of the whites. I don't know what I'm doing. Some of this white silvery shade. I kind of feel like it's missing something. Yeah. Oh, that's exactly what it was missing. Okay. Just kind of blend out using that. Whoop! Okay. Now for the other side, we're just going to do a regular, okay, I'm going to spritz my face. I'm going to show you guys as well how I kind of get that glow on my face. I am just going to spritz my face. Let me cover up this. This is my favorite, you guys. This is kind of the Wet n Wild. This is my favorite. Okay, and while we're letting that dry a little bit, I'm gonna go back in with the very same shade just to kind of, where is my angle brush? My stuff is everywhere. Okay. I'm gonna go back in with the same wood which shade that we used on our eyes, I mean our eyebrows. Right. Anyway, that's it for this tutorial, you guys. And if you've come this far, I hope you guys give me a like. I hope you guys subscribe and all of that jazz. And I'll see you again in my next video. I will be uploading a schedule for this week on my Instagram, so make sure you follow me on Instagram as well to check out whenever I upload, because I do normally kind of put updates on my Instagram stories specifically. So make sure you check me out on Instagram. I'm at tamaracanham on all my platforms, on Facebook, on Twitter. I'm tamaracanham, so make sure you check me out on those social media platforms as well. Until next time, bye darlings.